Subject is English of standard 3rd and the name of the lesson is Let's Wait. Let's Wait is a monologue. Here, a girl like you who is studying in standard 3rd is very sad and she is sharing her feelings with us. Come on students, we will listen to her monologue. What is the meaning of monologue? First, we will understand this word. Okay? Monologue is a speech presented by a single character, most often to express their mental thoughts aloud, though sometimes also to directly address another character or the audience. Means here only one character will be there. And he or she or it, okay, and they are telling and they are sharing their experiences, their lifestyle or their feelings, etc., or their thoughts. Got this? And the next person or the audience, they will listen to the thoughts, expressions expressed by that character. Got this, students? Means altogether a single character will be there in monologue. Now in this monologue, a girl child like you is expressing her feelings to us. This is a child of standard 3rd. Now dear students, you can see her. She is very sad, isn't it? And she is going to express her feelings and her thoughts to us. Students, can you remember that one more monologue we have gone through? Yes. Can you remember the name of the lesson? Yes, that was A Honey Bee Speaks. In that lesson, means in that monologue, honey bee tells and expresses its lifestyle, isn't it? Like that only, this is also a monologue. Let's wait. We will start our monologue, okay? When things go against their wishes, little children sometimes feel very sad and lonely. Lonely means alone. Okay? They don't realize how much the people around them love them. It's only when they wait and think properly that they understand it. Let's hear what this girl has to say. Okay? Now the monologue starts here. These sentences are from the girl's side. Okay. See, this is the worst day of my life. I am feeling very sad. You may not believe it, but I am the saddest person on this earth. Nobody loves me. I am very, very sad. I am the saddest person on the earth and no one notices me. The reason is that nobody loves me. I have a family. The reason for my sadness is I have a family. In my family, I have a mummy, daddy, granny and a younger sister. I have been sitting here for the whole day. Okay, for the last 8 hours. Okay, okay, alright, alright. At least an hour. No, at least 10 whole minutes. And no one has noticed me. and they all are interested only in my sister. They think that I am not there, so I am alone and I am sad. They all are enjoying life with my sister. They are ignoring me. So I am very, very sad. They are all interested only in my sister, even when she cries for no reason. They all rush to her, pick her up, and give her whatever she wants. Means they all are trying to fulfill her wish. And all are ignoring me. My mummy, my daddy, and my granny. Now I am fed up with all this. I am thinking that I should really go away and live in some interesting places. Now, I will become a hermit and wander in the mountains and in the forests. A hermit means a person who prefers to live alone. I will eat the fruit on trees and make friends with birds and animals. I will not stay in home. I will go out. Because I am very, very sad. I could ride away on a camel and live in a desert. And at night, I will sleep in a tent. Or better, still, I will travel to the North Pole and live in an igloo made of ice. You can see here, this is an igloo. Igloo is a type of house made of ice. Okay, you can see in the polar region. And I will make friends with the polar bear. We can see polar bears in polar region. So I will make friends with the polar bears. What's that? Something soft against my back. Oh, it's you. Baby, what are you doing here? You silly, go away. Don't smile at me. Why do you follow me? Is there nobody else in the house to look after you? Don't come here. You may bump into anything or something and I will get all the scolding. Why do you have to do everything that I do? Copycat. Oh, never mind. Really, the people in this house, they should look after her better. I am a grown-up girl now. I can manage on my own. But what about this little baby? Come, baby, let's crawl out from here. Now she is a little happy. Baby, when I go away, I will take you with me, okay? Or you will keep crying for me all the time and they won't even guess what the matter is with you. I really can't go away when you are so small. Let's wait till you are a little older. So I will change my decision. I won't go now, okay? Now, the girl is thinking about the little sibling. And this girl, she is playing with her sister. I really can't go away when you are so small. Let's wait till you are a little older. And now she is very happy with that baby. The girl who was angry and sad now was thinking about her small sister. And she came to know that her sister is very small and she can't do anything without the help of her parents. So she too accepted her misunderstanding and promised her sister to help and accompany her. Now she understood the situation and became happy. Now students, we will see what she tells about herself. What she is telling? She is telling that I am the happiest child in the world because she understood the situation. Now students, this girl is very happy and she is telling that my family is a happy family. Children, sometimes in our life too, some bad and sad situations come. But not to worry. We must be calm and peacefully think about the matter. Then everything will become normal. Like the things change in this girl's life. Okay? Now we will move to the hard words. In this lesson, some new words are there. We will move to the meaning of these hard words. Hermit. Hermit means, see this picture. A person who prefers to live alone without contact with other people. They wanted to live alone and they remain far away from all people. Scolding. See here, the mother is scolding the children. Why? Because they did something wrong or they did the mistake. Here, the meaning is to speak angrily to somebody because he or she has done something bad or wrong. Crawl. See here, this child is crawling. To move slowly on your hands and knees. This action is called as crawling. Answer the following questions. First one, where does the girl plan to go? Now we know, correct? Answer is, the girl plans to go to interesting places like mountains and forests or to desert or to the North Pole, isn't it? Here we have to write the answer in full sentence. Second, can a little girl go to such a faraway places on her own? Can she go alone? Answer, no. A little girl can't go to such a faraway places on her own. Third question is the girl sad at the end? You know the monologue, you know the story of that girl. Come on, tell me, is the girl sad at the end? You are right. Answer is No, the girl isn't sad at the end. At the end, she became happy, isn't it? Fourth one, does the girl love her little sister? Yes, the girl loves her little sister, isn't it? Now, dear students, see this. This is called contraction. See, this is a rubber. When we pull this, it expands. And when it comes to the original state, that is contracted state. This is called contraction and expansion. Okay? Got this? Now, in English also, there are some forms. That is full form and contraction form. Contraction means the smaller form. Full form means lengthier one, otherwise expanded form. Okay, we will go through some of them. It is, this is the full form, and the contraction form is its. See how we write, we use apostrophe. Okay, then we write s. How we read that? Its. It is means its. Got that? Is not. Is not. The contracted form or the contraction form is isn't. I S N apostrophe T. Isn't. How we say? Isn't. Okay? Next one. Do not. This is the full form. And the contraction form is don't. D-O-N apostrophe T. Don't. Okay. Next one. Did not. Yes. Can you guess what is the contraction form? Yes, you are right. Didn't. The spelling is D-I-D-N apostrophe T. But the pronunciation is didn't. Okay. Next one is has not. And the contraction form is hasn't. H-A-S-N apostrophe T. Hasn't. Will not. See here. The contraction form is won't. W-O-N apostrophe T. Won't. Will not. Won't. Okay. Write the things. Any three that make you sad. Sometimes you become sad now. That you have to write the things when you became sad. And when you became angry. Here also you can write the three things. Okay. And when you become happy, that also you have to write. Okay. This is for self-study. Make small sentences and write your feelings. Okay.